January 7th. The moon and the planet Jupiter keep close company tonight. Jupiter looks like a brilliant star quite close to the left or upper left of the moon as they climb into good view in mid-evening. Over the next few months, we'll get our first good looks at some worlds that are smaller than the moon, two of the solar system's dwarf planets. First up is Ceres, the largest member of the asteroid belt. The Dawn spacecraft is scheduled to enter orbit around it in early March. Water seems to have played an important role in the history of Ceres. Much of its surface consists of clays, which form in the presence of liquid water. And a space telescope found water vapor around Ceres. That suggests that liquid water still pools below the surface and squirts into space through cracks in the crust. Not long after Dawn settles into orbit, the New Horizons spacecraft will be turning its cameras toward its target, Pluto. The craft is scheduled to fly just a few thousand miles above Pluto in July.
NPR member stations, and from Cancer Treatment Centers of America, offering weekend appointments to help patients maintain their weekday schedules and routines while undergoing treatment.
But despite the old school exterior, Bratton has continued to reinvent himself and his profession. He took over the NYPD for the first time in 1994 when he introduced reforms like CompStat, a system that tracks crime and arrests, and he embraced the theory of broken windows, the idea that police should be tough on small quality of life crimes to prevent bigger crimes from happening. Crime in New York City dropped for the first time in decades. Departments across the country adopted his innovations. Then in 2002, Bratton took over the top job at the Los Angeles Police Department, which had a terrible relationship with the industry.
But you might get a better feel for what's happening in that industry by traveling south to a non-union parts plant in a place like Selma, Alabama. That's where Latasha Irby works, making foam car seats for a Hyundai supplier. After 9 years on the job, Irby makes $11.33 an hour.
Penguins Expect Electricity announced Tuesday that they're backing out of their purchasing contracts.
So this is very bad news for Cape Wind.
That's Audra Parker, the president of a group called the Alliance to Protect Nantucket Sound, which has led the onslaught against Cape Wind, challenging every regulatory and permitting
standard. For the Omaha metro area, tonight increasing cloudiness with a low around 3 below zero, wind chills of 10 to 20 below zero. Thursday, partly sunny, breezy, and not as cold, with a high in the upper 20s, winds becoming northwest at 20 to 30 miles an hour. Thursday night, partly cloudy and breezy, with a low near zero, with wind chills of 10 to 20 below. This is KIOS-FM, Omaha Public Radio. It's 10 minutes before 5 o'clock.
From NPR News, it's All Things Considered. I'm Robin Siegel.
And I'm Melissa Block. Michelle Cerros gave voice to a generation of young Mexican-Americans through her short stories, poems, and her memoir, How to Be a Chicana Role Model. Cerros died of cancer on Sunday at her home in Berkeley, California. She was 48. And NPR's Mondo Lutelberg has an appreciation. Michelle Cerros was a new kind of Latina writer. She didn't speak Spanish much, listened to ABBA. She was a vegan who liked to surf and skateboard. She made wisecracks about breakfast cereal, graffiti tigers, and thumping sound systems.
Why can't I be like those cool girls and like the cars that go boom, ba, boom?
Cerros was a college student in 1993 when her first book was published, titled Chicana Falsa and Other Stories of Death, Identity, and Oxnard.
NPR's Alice Fordham reports that after a decade of war, the river is slowly coming back to life.
It's a cool, sunny winter day in Baghdad, and on the banks of the River Tigris is moored what I could only describe as a party boat. There's tinsel snake.
At last report, both Omaha and Lincoln reporting clear skies, with 8 degrees in Lincoln, 4 degrees at Omaha Epley. This is KIOS-FM, Omaha Public Radio, broadcasting 24 hours a day and streaming on the web at KIOS.org. It's 5 o'clock. Stay tuned.
These men who was in this woman died for the idea they had of France. That is, freedom.
The president of France calls for unity after today's massacre at the office of a satirical newspaper. From NPR News, this is All Things Considered. I'm Melissa Bond.
And I'm Robert Siegel. 12 people were killed in Paris today when gunmen stormed the offices of a satirical weekly newspaper. The masked men shouted Islamist slogans as they killed the leading cartoonists of the magazine and the police guarding them. There's now a national manhunt for the perpetrators of the worst terrorist attack in France in decades.
And who are some of the people you met with when you were there? Like, what kinds of people did you seek out in order to better understand what day-to-day life was like there?
I met with Cuban government officials, I met with dissidents, I met with government journalists, I met with independent bloggers, I met with gays and lesbians. And then I also made an effort to just talk to random people on the street, Cuban socialism. But they are taking some pretty strong shots at the corruption, the bureaucracy, the salaries, the scarcity of food, the gap between what Cubans earn in their official jobs and how much money it costs just to get by in Cuba. And I think that has sparked a really interesting civil society community. And I think if we were to find a way to expand internet access on the island, which the Raul Castro, the Cuban government, has pledged to do, and the Obama administration is interested in facilitating, I think these discussions and these debates could reach a wider audience. I think that'd be very helpful.
My guest is Ernesto Londoño. He wrote the series of New York Times editorials that advocated for normalizing relations with Cuba. We'll be back after a break. This is Fresh Air.